Cause I'm not trying to pressure you. Just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend. I just wanna know your name, and maybe sometime we can hook up, hang out, just chill. How's it going, everybody? My name is Cisco, and thank you for stopping by. Now, 2018 is coming to an end, and I wanted to talk about the year that I've had. Specifically, living alone. Now, at the beginning of the year, me and my fiance actually bought the house that I am in right now, and I know it's supposed to be living alone, but it's very, very different from when I was living with my parents and my family. So there's a lot of things over the year that I've learned about living alone, good and bad, that I'd like to share with you guys, just in case you happen to be planning on moving out yourself. So just jumping into it, here goes 5 good and bad things about living alone. All right, so I'm gonna be starting off with the good list, and at number one is gonna be sleeping wherever and wherever. Living with family, you're gonna wanna be courteous to everyone else, and you're not gonna wanna stay up late making a ruckus for your sister or brother or your parents to hear. So typically you fall asleep at about the same time that they do, or you try to keep it a little bit quiet. Or sometimes you come home from school or work and you just happen to be watching TV on the couch and doze off. One of the best things about living alone is when you fall asleep, no one's gonna disturb you. Now, I know it's not really a good thing to fall asleep wherever and whenever, but if you are hanging out on the weekend and you just wanna fall asleep on the couch watching TV or movies, why not? Just do it. The main thing is that no one's gonna be kicking at your feet trying to wake you up for you to go to bed to go back to sleep. Now, following up with number 2 is actually gonna be not having to worry about anybody else in the house. So without having to worry about anybody else, you can literally do whatever you want. If you wanna walk around naked, by all means, no one's gonna stop you, even though it's kinda weird. So coming up at number 3 is going to be eat whatever you want, wherever you want, whenever you want. So if you want to eat ice cream for breakfast or you want to eat dinner on the couch, you could do so. No one's going to be really judging you. Maybe your doctor. So living at home, typically your parents are going to be worried about what you're eating, how much you're eating, making sure you're getting enough vegetables, yada yada, this and that, this and that. You don't got to worry about that anymore. Even though honestly you should. And piggybacking off of number 3, number 4 is going to be not having to worry about your leftovers disappearing. Now sometimes you go eat out and you have leftovers, you take it home and you want to eat it for later. If you put it in the fridge, it's finders keepers, honestly. At least it wasn't my house. Sometimes I would bring home food and leave it in the fridge, and sometimes it would just come up missing and there'd be no one who ate it, apparently. But living at home, when you take leftovers home and you put it in the fridge, when you wake up, it'll be there. Number 5 on the list is going to be organizing everything the way you want. Now, depending if you're a really neat freak, need to be really organized, or if you're kind of a slob and just don't care how everything is, you can have it the way you want to. No one's gonna be judging. As you can see behind me, my desk is kind of clean. Normally it is really messy. I like to be organized, but no one's on my back about making sure it stays organized, which I really like. Now personally, I do really like to be organized and clean, but sometimes I just don't have the time to, and I don't really want anyone to bother me about it. So if your desk gets a little bit messy or your bathroom sink doesn't get organized, no one's gonna bother you about it. Now let's get into the 5 bad things. Number 1 is going to be nobody cleans up after you. Now, like I just said, no one's gonna be bothering you if your room is a mess, but you gotta realize that no one's gonna be doing it for you. Your laundry's not gonna get washed magically, the dishes don't do themselves, the house doesn't get vacuumed, nothing gets dusted. You suddenly realize that all the responsibility is on you and you gotta take care of it. And no matter how long you procrastinate that, it will be waiting for you. Coming in at number 2 is going to be food doesn't magically appear either. So like I said before, one of the pros is being able to eat whatever you want. The con about it is you gotta make it or you gotta go buy it. And sometimes after a long day of work, you don't want to stop by the fast food place to go pick up some food, and you really don't want to cook when you get home. You just want to sit down and eat, and there isn't a meal waiting for you. So what I have learned is to stock up on snacks, microwave food, instant ramen. These will hold you off long enough for you to get the motivation to go buy some real food or make some real food. All right, number three is going to be, it's kind of creepy at night. When you're living with family, you're gonna hear steps, you're gonna hear noises, you're gonna hear sounds. It's all part of living with family. But you kind of know where they're coming from. You can recognize like your sister's footsteps or your mom yelling at the TV or someone talking on the phone. You can recognize that. But when you're living alone, it's really, really quiet if you don't have anything playing. If you don't have music playing, if you don't have the TV on, if your computer's off, it's just really creepy. Especially at night when you're trying to fall asleep, if you don't have any type of like ambient noisemaker or like you have music playing while you sleep, it's just dead. And the idea of you being alone in a house, alone in the dark, it's really, really kind of just like in the back of your head where you're just like, oh yeah, if I die, no one's gonna find out for a few days. Now, this is something you get over eventually, but I can't even lie. When my fiance was transitioning and moving over, I was here by myself. Oh man, it's hard to sleep. You can find me at night with a flashlight strapped to my hand. So coming in at number four is going to be the bills. You don't know, you don't realize all the bills they have to pay until you have to start paying it. Things that you take for granted, like all the utilities, the internet, TV, they pile up. Now you can try to live off of your phone, but you can only stare at this tiny little screen for so long. Not to mention all the groceries you have to buy, any small little things that you need for the house, like toilet paper, paper towels, cleaning supplies. And when living at home, it's just really easy just to go down to like your bathroom sink or kitchen sink and pick up whatever cleaning supplies you need to go wipe your desk down. And coming in at number five, the thing that I took most for granted is not having my family around. Now, before moving in with my fiance, I was always living with my family, whether it be my mom, my dad, or at my sister's house with her family. I always had them around. Now, at the very beginning, it's actually really, really sad because you have this feeling of separation and loneliness because they were always there. And over time, you do get used to it, but I personally feel that I haven't gotten over like them not being around. Not only is it the presence that you're gonna miss, but it's all these small things that you kind of take for granted. Things like telling you good morning, telling you to drive safe when you leave, making you food for when you get home, cleaning up after you, and just being able to tell them I love you and give them a hug. It's the small little things that they did for you while you were together that you really, really miss. And with that, I want to say I love you, Mom and Dad. Thank you for everything that you've done, everything that I've taken for granted. Y'all the real MVPs. All right, you guys, I hope you like my list. When I moved out at the beginning of the year, I thought I was ready, and you know, I kind of realized that I wasn't. I don't think anybody really expects everything that you have to do when you move out. You kind of just have to roll with the punches. And I hope this list maybe helps you out if you're planning on moving out, maybe get you into the right mental state and prepare for what is to come. And don't get me wrong, I do love living by myself, even though, you know, I'm with my fiance. She helps out a lot as well. But it is gonna be very, very different from living with your family. Anyways, thank you to everyone who has subscribed recently. I'm climbing to 300 subscribers. Thank you very much, I do greatly appreciate it. If you haven't yet, and you like the content and want to see more, please hit the subscribe button down below. Ring the bell to be notified every time I upload a video. Follow me on all my handles. It's at Cisco Pangan at Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. I couldn't think of all three for some reason. And if you want to as well, go ahead and hit the thumbs up button. It does make me feel good about myself. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys have a lovely day, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.